Hello, this is Kevin Herring. Welcome to TI's functional safety training video. In this video, we will discuss fit rates. Presentation summary. Functional safety standards like IEC 61508 and ISO 26262 require that semiconductor device manufacturers address both systematic and random hardware failures. This is an introductory presentation that provides an overview of fit rate and fit rate standards and TI's functional safety certification process. What you'll learn in this video is what is a fit rate and a brief review of fit rate standards, what is the difference between functional safety fit rate and technology fit rate, and finally, an introduction to TI's certification process. Fit rate overview. Functional safety standards require that semiconductor device manufacturers address both systematic and random hardware failures. Systematic failures are managed and mitigated by following rigorous development processes. This should theoretically eliminate systematic failures. Random hardware failures must adhere to specified quantitative metrics in order to meet hardware safety integrity levels, sometimes referred to as SIL, or automotive safety integrity level, sometimes referred to as ASIL. Systematic failures are excluded from the calculation of random hardware failure metrics. Base failure rates, BFR, quantify the intrinsic reliability of the semiconductor component while operating under normal environmental conditions. BFR is typically multiplied by factors such as temperature, voltage, and number of operating hours to arrive at a quantitative measure of the reliability of the component. One of the primary inputs for calculating random hardware metrics, as required by functional safety standards, is the BFR. It can be estimated by a variety of techniques. Siemens SN29500 fit model. SN29500 is a Siemens AG standard for the reliability prediction of electronic and electromechanical components. It's a lookup table approach to find reference fit rate and temperature for various component types. ICs, discrete semiconductors, passive components, switches, relays, lamps, connectors, etc., can all be found in this standard. The table below is an example of functional safety fit rates according to SN29500. For simple devices like resistors, capacitors, and diodes, the fit rate is very low, with a fit rate of 1 to 2. More complicated devices, like switching regulators, can have a fit rate in the range of 10 to 20. And some MCUs that are more complex could have a fit rate in the range of 150. IEC TR62380 fit rate analysis for integrated circuits. The IEC 62380 standard is another method that's common when estimating base failure rate in functional safety analysis. The general formula for IEC 62380 IC failure rate can be modeled as the sum of the die-related failure rate and the package-related failure rate, where die-related failure rate formula includes terms for IC type and IC technology, transistor count, thermal emission profile, junction temperature, operating and operating lifetime. The package-related failure rate formula includes terms for mechanical stresses due to thermal expansion, thermal cycles, thermal emission profile, package type, and package material. Electrical overstress failure rate formula includes terms for specific systems with external interface and electrical environment. The IEC 62380 model has been incorporated into ISO 26262 2018 Part 11. IEC 62380 and or SN29500 fit rate and failure mode requirements. All TI product lines and business units that provide functional safety fit rate and failure mode distribution to customers based on IEC's TR62380 and or SN29500 must do the following. The product line must follow the standard TI template for this document type. The product line must also get an official literature number from the technical publications team. FIT, MTBF, and Lambda. What do these numbers mean? FIT, MTBF, and Lambda are sometimes confusing and often used in the same context. all our values derive from statistics and probability. Fit is the number of failures in time interval of 10 to the 9th hours of operation. That is, the fit number is the number of failures in 1 billion hours of operation. MTBF is also given in hours, and it stands for mean time between failures. For non-repairable systems, for example, electronic components, the meaning is MTTF, which is mean time to failure. And finally, lambda is given in hours to the minus first. It is a failure rate, which is the number of failures in 1 hour. Functional safety fit versus technology fit. What is the difference? The functional safety fit rate is different than the technology fit rate. The TI Online MTBF Fit Estimator provides a technology fit rate that is derived using the JESD85 methodology from intrinsic silicon-only HTOL and ELFR reliability testing. HTOL stands for High Temperature Operating Life, and ELFR stands for Early Life Failure Rate. The derived MTBF and FIT are estimated with a 60% confidence interval for reliability. This method provides an accurate FIT rate for the process or die technology, but does not consider silicon package interactions or other important factors. TI also provides a functional safety FIT rate for some components, and it's based on one of two standards, IEC 62380 or SN 29500, which are both calculated based on a 90% confidence interval. Which TI products include a functional safety fit rate calculation? The answer is simple. All TI functional safety products promoted for applicability in functionally safe systems come with a functional safety fit rate calculation. In addition to the functional safety fit rate, TI products promoted as functional safety capable will have a failure mode distribution and or pin failure mode analysis, also known as pin FMA report, that adheres to a standard TI-wide format. This level of documentation is typically provided for less complex devices. TI products promoted as functional safety quality managed or functional safety compliant will have a more comprehensive document set in addition to the functional safety fit rate. This higher level of documentation is typically available for more complex devices. A complete description of available documents for TI's functional safety categories can be found at www.ti.com/functional-safety, as all one word. This concludes our TI functional safety video on fit rate. To learn more about functional safety at TI, go to www.ti.com/functional-safety, as all one word. Thank you for watching.